Tony Gwynn, Marvell Wynn, and then McReynolds. A drive to left field, back to the wall goes McReynolds, gone!
From Montreal.
Owen ne bouge pas, la balle est frappée, Céline dans la direction de champ gauche. Croc à la piste à l'avertissement. Circuit, Gary Carter, le kid!
To the Mets.
And this one deep to left, it is going, it is gone, goodbye.
Gary Carter, an 11-time All-Star, twice the game MVP. Gary, over here, the Silver Sluggers, you got five of them.
I got an 81, 82, 84, 85, 86.
At 18, he signed his first contract, earning the nickname Kid.
So what about this guy, young guy in Montreal?
Oh, yeah, look at the hair. About that hair? Huh? That was a picture that my agent actually had painted and gave it to me as a gift.
There's the drive, way back. It might be the 300th home run of his career.
Carter is considered one of the best-hitting catchers of all time, a gung-ho leader on the field who brought an old-fashioned intensity to the ballpark.
I never cheated anybody. I always played the game hard, and I always respected the game for what it meant.
You see this, what goes through your head?
Well, the first thing is obviously the trade from Montreal to New York, and then, of course, the World Championship.
Considered the last piece of the championship puzzle, Carter took New York by storm.
You kind of feel like, wow, this is pretty wild, to walking into an appearance and them grabbing Gary, you know, and yelling and screaming and tugging at you and everything.
They got all of them in 1986 as he led the Mets to the World Series.
Another one, a towering smash. Rice never even moved.
Carter cracked two homers in Game 4 and delivered a crucial hit in the team's miraculous two-out, 10th-inning rally in Game 6.
We were the never-say-die Mets that year anyway. We had so many tremendous comebacks, and it was like, my gosh, when that ball went through Buckner's legs, it was like, what just happened? It happened so quickly. As a kid growing up, you dream about playing in a World Series. Back then, when you're a kid growing up, you don't think about the ring. But then it's emphasized so much because it's a ring that you can't buy. You have to earn it.
Gary Edmund Carter, Kid.
In 2003, after 19 years in the bigs, Carter was enshrined in Cooperstown.
Can you feel it? It is so sweet.
I just enjoyed the game so much and had a passion and a love for the game so much that was my reward.
Now he's out of the game, a Hall of Famer who's been turned down for several jobs in the majors.
It's disappointing and it's frustrating, and I'm hoping something will materialize for the future, but if you take the game totally away and say I can't be in uniform anymore or I can't do anything involving the game, that would be like tearing my heart out.
But he was a successful manager in the minors.
When I got back in uniform, I felt the kid come out of me again. And I think that's the great thing about coaching or managing is that you have that feeling again.
A feeling.
Runner at three, no outs.
He gets vicariously through his daughter, Kimmy, the head softball coach at Palm Beach Atlantic University.
I learned from the best.
As a father, I just appreciated her hard work at becoming the player that she became.
A catcher, just like her dad.
He's 6'2", I'm 5'2", and so I put on his gear, the knees were way up to my, you know, thighs.
She was a little fire plug. I mean, even in high school and college, I mean, there would be big girls come sliding in to try and, you know, knock her over and all, and she stuck her nose right in there.
Now Kimmy's brought her experience to a once struggling program.
The challenging part is that they didn't see me for the years before, so it's a new philosophy, new way of coaching, new way of pushing them.
And her father.
Nice going.
Oh.
I'll see you.
Couldn't be prouder.
I know for a fact that Kimmy has really turned that program around.
As for his own future, he's optimistic the game he loves will give him one more turn at bat.
I'm hoping what's next is that I get an opportunity to manage somewhere. I don't know what organization it'll be in. I have it in my blood, Corey. I can't get enough of it. I mean, it's been a part of my life ever since I was a little guy.